Hello, everybody. Welcome to OVO Olympic View Opinions, where students from Olympic View Elementary share their thoughts on different subjects. Today, we have sixth graders joining us, and today's topic is sixth grade camp. All right. So, let's start off introducing ourselves. I'm going to start right here. On my left-hand side, I have...
Hi, my name is Elizabeth.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Hi, my name is Alana.
Hi, my name is Pauline.
Hi, my name is Ian.
Hi, my name is Dominic.
And you're all sixth graders, right?
Yeah.
From what school?
Olympic View.
What the? That's where we're doing our podcast, right?
Yeah.
Right. So, okay. So, today's topic... it's going to be sixth grade camp. So I heard that you recently went to sixth grade camp, right?
Yeah.
Well, let's start off with, where is sixth grade camp located?
Sixth grade camp is located near Julian. The town of Julian.
Okay, Julian.
At Raintree Ranch.
Raintree Ranch. Okay, and how many days were you there?
Four. Like about
a week.
Four.
Four.
Three. Four.
Four.
3 to 4 weeks.
3 and a half. Probably.
3 days.
3 days and two nights, something like that.
Four days and two nights.
So we went up there.
Wednesday, Thursday.
We stayed there.
And then we came back Friday. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Okay.
All right. So let's start off with talking about
sleeping.
What do you guys want to talk about first?
Sleeping.
Sleeping.
No, let's do like first impressions.
Okay. Let's go. What was your first impression? Impression of Camp Marston?
It was pretty small. It was smaller than what I thought.
Okay, you thought it was going to be bigger?
Yeah.
I thought it was kind of big, but okay.
I'm going to talk about the play area first. So basically, there's this like large soccer field, this is what most people would play throughout the days. And then there's this rock climbing area. Bro, for tall people, you were already touching the ceiling. You couldn't even climb it.
Exactly.
Oh yeah, the little house that you had to.
I thought you were talking about the rock climb wall.
Yeah. Oh, that was the activity.
Not the hut.
Yeah. Alana's talking about the.
Yeah, the hut.
I thought it was gonna be like really cold, and then we caught out, and I was like, it's kind of hot, guys.
Yeah. Well, yeah. It was. They said it was gonna be really, really cold, but we got a good weather up there.
It didn't snow. It was only at night. It turned cold.
So let's say like fifth graders who might be listening to this show, what can they expect when they go to sixth grade camp? Go ahead, just talk.
A lot of hiking. If you are in Cabin Bunkhouse, then you'll be doing midnight hiking every day.
Nah, it wasn't midnight hiking. It was like 9 p.m.
It was at 10.
No, it was 8. It was 8.
Yeah, because you had to be at bedtime at 9 or something.
Well, people should expect like being outdoors and having like an adventurous time. And they have to like get used to being like being social and stuff, because there's also going to be other schools there that you have to interact with.
Yeah, and that's something like that could be a little bit scary to some people, right? Like you have
especially
to,
especially because like your parents aren't there.
Your parents are not there, but then you're also sharing the place with people that you've never seen before.
Also, in the cabins, they put you with random people, and you have to like get to know each other, and you just hang out.
Yeah, that's cool. Any other? What's that? So any other things that you would like to share out about? Okay, you mentioned cabins. How were the cabins? Were they good?
They were heated with like bathrooms and stalls for privacy.
Okay, so there was privacy, because that's one of the things that a lot of people are scared of. Like the kids, is everybody going to see me when I shower? What is it, Pauline?
They told us in the video it was going to be like 2 minute showers, but it ended up being like 5 minutes.
But you also had to like dry yourself off and get ready.
So it's really like 3 minutes. It takes two minutes because you also have to get changed in the stall.
Well, what is the one thing that they're trying to help like make you do? But why?
Because there's a lot of kids in one cabin and there's only like
three or four showers per cabin.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, there's about like 25 people in each cabin, and there's like four showers. At least in my cabin, there was four showers.
And not only like we have to be fast so everybody gets time to shower, but they're also trying to conserve some water, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. Anything else that you wanna?
Oh, the first people that were like to take a shower, they were like screaming. They're like, "Oh my gosh, it's so cold!" And then when I got in, it was like super warm for me.
So the drive up there, was it a long ride?
Oh yeah, it was like an hour and a half, 2 hours.
It felt longer, but then when you keep on doing it, like when you did it the second time, it felt really short.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, but on the ride back, it was kind of crowded because we had to wait for the bus.
We had to wait for the other bus, but yeah, it was a really good experience. All right, let's talk about food. How about that food?
Food in the morning, best thing.
It's like
there's like whipped cream in
the
morning.
Hold on. Let's talk about how they separated the tables. Basically, on the first day, when we went to go eat lunch, they all made us line up in one large line, and they would just tell each person a table, and it would be like your table one, your table two, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So you were put with random people, and there's this thing called the spatula and a walker. So if you wanted to get up and grab food, you had to grab the spatula to get up, and you had to wait for the spatula to return to your table.
And it was also, what do they call it? Family meat?
What? Oh, family style.
Family style. Oh, yeah. That was one of the things that I think a lot of kids had difficulty with because they didn't know how family style worked, right? Did you guys learn how to do it?
Yeah, I usually do that with my family.
So what is, just say it so like people who are listening, they know what family style.
It's like you get a tray and then it's full of the food and then you serve yourself first and then you pass it down to other people and you don't have to.
Okay.
You have to get one.
Yeah. All right. And what if the food ran out? Like, is it?
We can ask for seconds.
Oh,
like,
seconds.
So the walker asks like who wants seconds and then we all raise our hand. And then whoever wants seconds, that walker will go up to the cafeteria and then ask for that amount of seconds.
What about like students who can't eat certain foods?
You would go have to line up. They'll call your name separately before it all starts. And then you basically just get the same food, but allergy free.
Okay. Yeah. So like they will meet the needs of like the dietary needs.
Yeah. Like instead of eggs, you'll get like fake eggs.
Fake eggs. You also mentioned the salad was one of your favorites.
The fruit bar.
The salad/fruit bar. Because
that was
really
good. It was
only a fruit bar in breakfast and salad bar in lunch and dinner.
And all fresh food and fresh salad.
The strawberries were really good.
Strawberries. Especially with the whipped cream.
Yeah.
Wow. What was your favorite food up there?
Chicken Alfredo.
Chili.
Chili.
It was chili.
I agree.
And I know the drinking part was something that they made you do.
Oh, yeah.
God.
What?
You had to drink three cups
there,
of milk.
I'm sorry. I hated the water.
I love the water.
Yeah, but the rule is, so, like, you have to drink three cups of water each meal.
Three cups of water each meal? Why do you think...
No, each meal. No, you have to drink three cups of water, like, a day.
Right?
No.
Each meal.
No, you need to drink three cups of water to get juice.
Oh, there's juice.
Yeah. No, just in general, too.
Yeah.
I heard that there was, like, some cool teacher who would, like, make some special juice, too.
Oh, yeah, our table.
I wonder who.
It was somebody that starts with, like, a Mr. T.
I guess, I don't know. I just heard
maybe
he was dope.
There's a different teacher, and she was like, "You guys want juice?" And then she just mixed up all of the juices and gave it to you. It was really good.
There was also chocolate milk.
Okay, so let's move on from we talked about the drive. We talked about the place itself. How about some of the activities? Like, what you do up there for the whole day? Go ahead, Ian. All right, Pauline. Anyone?
Someone talk.
Okay. So the activities, they're pretty fun. So the activities are separated between different days. So we started the activities on Wednesday, and it's I think 2 or 4. Is it 2 or 4 activities?
There's
a day.
Like.
Well, name the activities that were there.
Basically, there were one in the morning and one in the afternoon.
Yeah.
And we did that for 2 days.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 3 hours. They were 3 hours long.
No, yeah, because one, two, one.
Well, just can you name the activities for people who are listening?
So it was
earth and water,
ecobility,
activities.
So they were kind. You went up there and you learn about different things. So it was kind of like you were in school, but it was just outdoor.
Nature.
Survival skills.
Oh yeah, survival.
Survival skills
was kind of. It was kind of like fun too.
Survival skills.
Because you were able to cook a hot dog on a fire.
And you had to make your own fire there?
No. They made it for you.
But the marshmallows up there.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. I had to make my own hot dog.
And you mentioned activities. What were some of those activities that you had?
Rock climbing.
Candle making. Hiking.
Hiking.
And all of those are...
Another one where you went down.
The slide. That wasn't for activities.
That was for behaving or something.
No, I used that as soon as we were starting to go up for the hike for... For survival skills. They were like, okay, you know what? Let's just go on the slide. And it was like right there.
Okay. So what was your favorite activity?
I like doing archery.
Did you get a bullseye?
No, I didn't even get it on
so there. Basically, it was a haystack, and it was divided into four parts.
What? What's so funny?
Okay. So there's this stack of hay that you're able to shoot at, and you just shot at it.
Okay.
And then a target was on it.
No, my counselor was like, we were like, are you going to put up the, like the board?
Like the paper?
Yeah, and then she was like, oh, I don't know how to do that.
Oh, yeah. I think that was like a problem because I saw like targets on the floor, but there's no targets on the hay.
Oh, okay. Maybe they fell off.
I didn't get it on the hay, guys.
I got it on the hay, but then when I went to go pick up my arrows, there was a target on the tree, like the tree trunk.
Oh yeah! Oh, I heard about that. I'm not gonna name any names, but somebody was like,
you gotta say it though. You gotta say it now. Maybe don't say the name, but say what happened though.
So somebody decided to tell another from our school, tell the person, like, because they were shooting like this way and it was going down, and they're like, how about you like shoot up like this, and then somebody was like in our school was like, how do you shoot up, and then there was a different girl from a different school and she was like, okay, and it landed on like the highest point of the tree.
Oh my gosh. But everything was very safe, right? Like
the arrows, they weren't like hunting arrows, they're called target arrows. There's no point.
It
kind of
looked like if like Nerf had arrows.
Yeah. But it was like made of like metal, plastic or metal.
Yeah.
As long as like you weren't shooting at each other, right?
No. That was one of the major safety rules.
Okay. Yeah. If you pointed it at someone, then you weren't able to.
I think you wouldn't even get to do anything else. Actually.
I accidentally shot an arrow into the tree.
Oh, you went to the tree already.
Me and my friend both did.
Another activity that it's one of the students' favorite, it's the rock climbing, right?
Oh, I made it to the top. I was like going to the top and then I was gonna like grab one, it was wiggly and I was like I dropped it.
Oh yeah, that's why I stopped because I think I ran out of my arms.
Bro, no, I went to the top. I wasn't looking down, I went to the top and I was about to go down. I was like, oh, that's a little
Pauline, which one was your favorite activity?
I like the rock climbing. I went all the way up.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I think
everybody went all the way up except, I'm not going to say no names. But she's sitting right in front of me.
Hey, I don't want to brag, but the instructor told me that I was the fastest.
He said the same thing to me.
No, he didn't even climb.
All my friends. He was like, wow, you're the fastest.
Oh, cool. All right, so the activity sounds so fun. The food sounds so good. The facilities, they were good. The cabins were warm when you needed to be warm.
How about sleeping?
What about sleeping?
Okay, if you're going to be sleeping with your friends, expect to be
loud.
Barely any sleep.
They won't
be quiet.
I saw you guys every morning. And a lot of you look like zombies. Like, you just, like, walking.
Did you see bunkhouse?
Bunkhouse is just full of bunks.
Yeah.
Okay, wow. So definitely when
you... I wonder what the bunkhouse.
Literally a bunkhouse.
So one day I did go to the bunkhouse just to check it out, and I thought the bunkhouse was like the prettiest cabin. Like it was, it looked so cool, so nice outside, right? As soon as I walked in, first, the smell. It was like, oh my gosh. Number two, and it was the boys' cabin, the boys were not there. They were hiking, but that's when I decided to go check it out. And every piece of clothing was everywhere except, like, where it's supposed to be. Like, it was on the ground.
Ew,
like
underwear,
you guys
guys?
Can't be
yes.
Ew.
I don't want to share any of what I... I'm not going to be going into specifics of what I saw, but it was terrifying.
Wait, right. What do you mean by that?
It was terrifying.
For a person that lived in the bunkhouse, it was actually kind of...
cozy.
It was kind of cozy, yeah. Because you're full of... Because you're, like with everyone. You're not in separate rooms, so it's kind of cozy. And it's kind of, like... I don't know how to explain it. It's like, it's just like fun.
Just like you guys are all together.
Yeah, we're all together. There's no, I think the walls make it so you like,
you just feel like a family room.
It's like, yeah. I love my counselors because when they would wake us up, it was like, I think 6:45 when they would wake us up. And they would be like, oh, you guys want to go check out the sunset? Like, you could go outside and, like, go back in. But it was so cold.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah.
I woke up to music every day.
Music was blasting in the morning, and it was not fun.
It's always Taylor Swift, too.
No, ours was the Lorax song.
They need to put some reggae in there, right, to make it.
I woke up to, not going to say any names, but someone saying, I lost my voice.
I know who said that.
We actually need to wrap this up already. So final comments, final thoughts, really quick. What are your final thoughts?
Overall, camp was really great, and I enjoyed my time there.
Cool.
It was fun, and I liked it.
Pauline?
It was fun.
It was fun. Boys?
For those who are going to go next, next year,
don't go from bunkhouse.
just wish you're not in bunkhouse. Okay. It's kind of
don't be because
you have to hike.
Too big.
You have to hike.
And thank you so much for listening to. Make sure you hit that follow button, subscribe, and let's keep going.
Bye.
Thank you for listening. OVO Olympic View Opinions.